Good morning. Had my lens in the poking through the wrong spot of the old drafting triangle that I use as my setup for this. It's crazy. I hope everyone slept well. It's been a while since I've done a reading in the morning. I'm kind of late to the party for a weekly intention setting spread, but here we go. I'm going to be using one by Brown Girl Tarot on Instagram and probably wherever else they are. Take a moment to center yourself, greet your ancestors, guides, shuffle your deck, etc. Set your intention. If you already have something you know you want, need to accomplish for this week, write it down. If not, pull a card to help identify what to work on. Try to avoid making a long list. Yes. Lay the spread. If you include a shadow card, pull it from the bottom of the deck, yes. Journal it all. Which is why I printed it in my little funky journal. And so let's clip this in here so it doesn't jitter around on me. Because I'm going to try something different. I'm not binding this one together right off the bat. And let's begin. I'm going to use two decks from Usi. One, the Pagan Otherworlds Tarot. And the other, their Supra Oracle. So I'm gonna take a load off and sit down. I usually stand. And let's see if my hands are working this morning. Sort of. This we're listening to is Garden Music by Kevin MacLeod. I've been getting a lot of swords lately. Essentially the shadow, so we will. I wasn't going to pull a shadow or piece of doodle paper to wake up my pens, it appears. It's time. Super deck for the two bottom positions, left and right, and don't mess myself up. I wonder if I did that. I'm anal, and that I like to keep my decks upright if the position warrants opposing, or sort of a, other side of the card's image. Bunch of information, then that's, I do that. But I like to keep everything upright. So, I think I did that. And I don't usually turn my deck when I cut it to shuffle. Hanging out there for a reason, so we will bring you up. Synchronicity. And I am going to do the cards above. this is, I'm not very good at voicing my opinions right off the bat. I was getting better at it when I first got into recording everything. Wow, this is going to be crazy. So let's... I'm going to go Emperor. Judgment. Oh, no, first quarter. Things along with thought. And gentleness. What do I need to do to manifest this intention? Thank you. critical thinking. Authoritative strength and knowledge. I shouldn't have cut that out, but oh well. What do I need to avoid to manifest this intention? Decisions. What do I need to acknowledge to manifest this intention? Page of Wands. Page of Wands has a spirit-like quality to him that is almost impish. He stands confidently looking out over an arid plain that he seems to have suddenly appeared on and where he looks a bit out of place. A messenger perhaps from an ancient woodland kingdom, but eager to set forth and explore this new world around him. He wears on his head and around his shoulders the resilient branches of the evergreen tree. Their fresh earthy smell energizes the air around him with the powerful scent of one of Earth's oldest trees. His face is half covered by a mask, carved from the skull of a mountain lion, whose pelt he wears as a cape, giving him keen vision and strength, especially in dark, unknown places. Around his waist, a small antler carved into a musical horn hangs from his belt. In the distance, a volcanic mound dominates the horizon. This is the card of the adventurer, one who has an openness for exploring the world around them and whose fearless creative leaps into the unknown are inspiring and visionary. They carry old souls and attract strong protectors, which is a good thing because their constant reaching for the new and unexplored often pushes them into dangerous, uncharted territory. Take a leap. Take a leap into adventure, into the unknown. How my ancestors and guides are helping me manifest this intention. Steady calm. Patient confidence, S on the end of there. And there we go. I hope everyone has a great hump day. Stay safe. Peace. Love you all. Toodles.